Chapter 1, Introduction of Statistics, 1.3, Collecting Sample Data. The method used to collect sample data influences the quality of the statistical analysis. Of particular importance is the simple random sample. If sample data are not collected in an appropriate way, the data may be so utterly useless that no amount of statistical torturing can salvage them. The gold standard. Randomization with placebo treatment groups is sometimes called the gold standard because it is so effective. A placebo, such as a sugar pill, has no medicinal effect. The basics of collecting data. Statistical methods are driven by the data that we collect. We typically obtain data from two distinct sources, observational studies and experiments. An experiment. We apply some treatment and then proceed to observe its effects on the individuals. The individuals in experiments are called experimental units, and they are often called subjects when they are people. Observational study, observing and measuring specific characteristics without attempting to modify the individuals being studied. For example, ice cream and drownings. An observational study would be to observe past data to conclude that ice cream causes drownings. This is based on data showing that increases in ice cream sales are associated with increases in drownings. The mistake is to miss the lurking variable of temperature and the failure to see that as the temperature increases, ice cream sales increase and drownings increase because more people swim. An experiment, to conduct an experiment with one group treated with ice cream while another group gets no ice cream. We can see that the rate of drowning victims is about the same in both groups, so ice cream consumption has no effect on drownings. Here, the experiment is clearly better than the observational study. To design an experiment, you must consider the following. Replication. Replication is the repetition of an experiment on more than one individual. Good user replication requires sample sizes that are large enough so that we can see effects of treatments. Blinding is a technique in which the subject doesn't know whether he or she is receiving a treatment or a placebo. Blinding is a way to get around a placebo effect, which occurs when an untreated subject reports an improvement in symptoms. Double blind. Blinding occurs at two levels. The subject doesn't know whether he or she is receiving the treatment or a placebo. The experimenter doesn't know whether he or she is administering the treatment or a placebo. Randomization is used when subjects are assigned to different groups through a process of random selection. The logic is to use chance as a way to create two groups that are similar. A simple random sample. A sample of N subjects is selected in such a way that every possible sample of the same size N has the same chance of being chosen. A simple random sample is often called a random sample, but strictly speaking, a random sample has the weaker requirement that all members of the population have the same chance of being selected, not that all samples of the same size N has the same chance of being selected, as in a simple random sample. Some other sampling techniques are systematic sampling, where you select some starting point and then select every kth element in the population. Convenience sampling is that you sample data that's very easy to get. Stratified sampling is when you subdivide the population into at least two different subgroups, or strata, so that the subjects within the same subgroup share the same characteristics. Then you draw a sample from each subgroup or stratum. Cluster sampling is when you divide the population area into sections or clusters. Then you randomly select some of the clusters and choose all of the members from those selected clusters. Multi-stage sampling occurs when you collect data by using some combination of the basic sampling methods. In a multi-stage sample design, pollsters select a sample in different stages, and each stage must use different methods of sampling. Observational studies, you observe and measure, but don't modify. There are several types of observational studies. A cross-sectional study, in which data are observed, measured, and collected at one point in time, not over a period of time. You have retrospective or case control studies, which the data are collected from a past time period by going back in time through examining records, interviews, and so on. And then you have a prospective or longitudinal or cohort study in which data are collected in the future from groups sharing common factors. They're also called cohorts. Confounding occurs in an experiment when the experimenter is not able to distinguish between the effects of different factors. Try to plan the experiment so that confounding does not occur. Controlling the effects of variables. Completely randomized experimental designs assign subjects to different treatment groups through a process of random selection. Randomized block design is when a block is a group of subjects that are similar, but blocks differ in ways that might affect the outcome of the experiment. Matched pairs design compare two treatment groups by using subjects matched in pairs that are somehow related or have similar characteristics. Rigorously controlled design are carefully assigned subjects to different treatment groups so that those given each treatment are similar in ways that are important to the experiment. Sampling errors occur no matter how well you plan and execute the sample collection process. Sampling error or random sampling error occurs when the sample has been selected with a random method, but there is a discrepancy between a sample result and the true population result. Such an error results from the chance sample fluctuations. Non-sampling error is the result of human error, including such factors as wrong data entries, computing errors, questions with biased wording, false data provided by respondents, forming biased conclusions or applying statistical methods that are not appropriate for the circumstances. And then non-random sampling error is the result of using a sampling method that is not random, such as using a convenience sample or a voluntary response sample.